Five options to speed up your older computer. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question. What is the best method to increase the speed and avoid something not responding from anything I try to open on my older computer? It can be very slow. This happens usually when I first start it up or after it's been on a while. Are there files or programs I could safely delete or move to an external drive to increase efficiency? Thanks. So to be clear, you're not alone. This is actually very common. Many people with older computers face this struggle regularly. The machine that they've carefully been using for years gets slower and slower over time, especially with each subsequent update of the operating system or their applications, because the operating system and the applications very slowly assume more and more powerful machines, leaving your older machine potentially in the dust. Fortunately, we have some options. Now, if I were in your shoes, if this were my older computer, and actually with only the information you've provided, I would sidestep all of the other options I'm going to talk about in a second and go nuclear. I'd back up completely and then reinstall Windows from scratch, downloading a Windows install disk if you don't have one of your own. The reason I would do that is that that gives you a clean install with nothing extra for that version of Windows. That's the bare minimum. That's the stuff you need to run Windows. Which version is going to depend on you and which version you can actually get installation media for. If you've got an older version of Windows that works well for you, sure, use it. If you've got a newer version of Windows available, Windows 10, Windows 11, give it a try. Maybe it'll work. Maybe it won't. Maybe it'll be too slow. But this is the time to figure that out. Then, perhaps even more importantly, I'd only reinstall the applications after considering one by one whether I actually need and will use them on this specific machine. Every installed application runs the risk of slowing down your machine just a little bit more. So this, more than anything, will tell you about the hardware limitations of your machine for the versions of Windows you're trying to run. If it's still slow after a reinstall of only what you need, then honestly, pursuing further software solutions isn't going to be particularly effective. So, option number two, hardware upgrades for your older computer. One of the most effective upgrades you can perform on an older computer is to replace its hard drive, its old magnetic disk spinning platter hard drive, with a solid state disk, an SSD. They are significantly faster than the old spinning hard drives and can really, really perk up a pokey machine. I've seen it myself. I've done it on a couple of machines where I've taken the old hard disk out and then replaced it with an SSD. The process is actually pretty simple. Create a full image backup of the machine, physically replace the hard drive, restore the image backup to your machine, and you should be good to go faster. The other traditional hardware upgrade, of course, is to add RAM if your computer is capable of handling more. Windows likes RAM, especially newer versions, because Windows itself is getting bigger and bigger, which means it's going to use more and more RAM, leaving less RAM left over for the applications you run, meaning that things will get slower. If you can give it some more headroom by providing some more RAM, then that is something worth doing. If this were my computer, and I was planning on keeping it for a while, I'd do both of these things. I would replace the hard disk with an SSD. I would update, add as much RAM as possible. In fact, that's usually one of the things that I will do to every machine I plan to keep for a while. Even though I may buy the machine with less than its capacity of RAM at the start, eventually, just as part of using the machine and part of seeing things grow, I will eventually max out the RAM on that machine. So, option number three, the purge. So let's say you don't want to reinstall from scratch, and you've maximized your hardware's capacity, or as I like to say, the capacity of your wallet. The next step is to get serious about getting rid of everything you can that's installed on your older computer. Visit Add Remove Programs in Control Panel, or Apps and Features in Settings, or run a tool like Revo Uninstaller and review the list of installed applications. Consider carefully whether or not you need every single one. Now, you might think that having an application installed but not running doesn't affect performance. In theory, that's absolutely true. However, many applications also install little helper apps that run all the time, from the time you boot up to the time you shut down, whether or not you're actually using that application. Those little helpers, they're little helpers, but they add up, and they can place a surprising burden on your system. So, if you don't really need the applications they're helping in the first place, an uninstall of that application should also get rid of the helper. Option number 4, clean up. This is not quite as impactful as most people think it will be, but simple disk maintenance can help speed up older machines. That falls into two categories: cleaning up and defragmenting. So start with the Windows built-in disk cleanup tools. Delete temporary files, consider clearing browser caches, files left over from Windows Update, and more. Particularly if your disk space was tight to begin with, freeing up space can sometimes speed up your machine. Now, if your older machine has an older hard drive, not yet updated to an SSD, then the Windows disk defragmenting tool should be run. With Windows 7 and later, you really don't need to worry that much about it since it happens automatically. However, particularly after a cleanup such as some of the things we just did, immediately running a defrag can help improve things a little bit. Option number 5. Abandon ship. And by ship, I mean Windows. Sometimes machines are simply too old and underpowered to run current or even recent versions of Windows. It's sad, in a way, that what was a trusty and powerful machine once might no longer make the cut. But it's also inevitable. So, one last alternative before disposing of the machine is to try a different operating system, like Linux. Now, there are a bunch of different flavors, or distributions as they call it, of Linux. And there are some that are specifically tailored to older computers that aren't as powerful as current models. Linux can actually work quite well on these machines. An older computer can make a perfect testbed for evaluating Linux, or it can be a useful way to extend the life of that older machine. As one example, right now, as I sit here recording this, in my basement is an older machine, happily running Ubuntu. It acts as a file backup and media server for my home network, and honestly has many good years ahead of it. Running current versions of Windows? That wouldn't work well. It would be a stretch at best. So, bottom line, you've got options. Regardless of which you choose, from a complete reset to a repurpose, there are several ways that you can lengthen the life of your older computer. For links, comments, updates, and more, visit askleo.com/107845. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.